So, tell us about what each phase of Sade Sati signify, like rising, peak, and setting phase.
That was another thing. It's like the rising, setting, and peak. So rising is when Saturn is in the 12th house, and peak is when it's exactly over your moon, and setting is when it is in the second house. So as I was telling before, it's like suppose you are sleeping in the dead of the night and somebody rings the bell, and then you open the door and that person says, "Excuse me, sir, you got this bill. You must pay the bills." So that's the first phase. But still, that time you are not paying the bills. In first phase of Sarasati, what happens? You come to know that your life is taking a different course, but you still don't attend to it, mind it. You still behave like the ostrich. So functionally you are the same, no difference. But the voice is growing inside, You must do, you must do, you must do, you must do. Ye karna hai, karna hai, karna hai. But you will not do it. Then what happens? By the first phase, when it ends, you are like, I can't. I must do the things which I always ignored. That is why you will see when Sarasati comes, people become vegetarians. Or sometimes they become vegans. They give up smoking, drinking, all these things. Why? Now, other people will think, oh, he Sarasati started na, so Saturn made him a very pure person. Their surrounding people, their relatives will think like this. But actually, what Saturn has done is Saturn has kicked that person right, left. Right, left kick. So because of that, what happens? In the first phase, you get a feeling that my life is demanding a different version of me. Oh, old version of me doing gossip around here, there, watching Facebook when I am in the company. Yes, attending late night parties till 12 o'clock. Or maybe till 4 a.m. in the morning. At least in Germany, I have a building in front of me. When I get up, they just end their parties that time. 6:37. That's the schedule here. Then whenever there is a vacation, instead of going to some divine places, you end up choosing to go to places, like Goa. Of course, you are going to a spiritual gathering in Goa. That's perfect. I have no problem with that. But that's not why people go to Goa. Even my family members, relatives, everybody is like, oh my God, we are searching for holidays. And I'm like, why, what happened? We just want to see how we can fit our Goa trip in. Even none of my family members, most nobody drinks. Even they want to go to Goa. Even when you are not drinking, you see. So in the first phase, you will realize that you get a feeling inside that if I stay the way I have stayed from last 20, 30 years, it will not work. It's not going to work. You get that feeling in the first phase. But you continue to behave like an ostrich. What you do in first phase is, in Assamese, there is a saying which perfectly fits into this. I don't know if this is there in Hindi or any other language, but it's there in Assamese. It is named, they say, Pani tha nosara obostha. This means the duck is there in the water, but it is not able to swim. Maybe there's something similar in Hindi, I don't know. So it means that your voice is growing, but your weakness is also so high, So it's like there's a competition going on. Your inner voice is going like this. First phase, it's going up. But your fear and that ostrich behavior is somewhere here. So when it touches this, your first phase ends. And then second phase starts. When second phase starts, the ostrich pulls out the head from the ground.
Okay.
Not because it wants to. He's forced to do that. Then the ostrich sees there is a snake, there is a lion, there is an elephant. Kabhi bhi mere ko kuchal sakte hai log. Then what it does? It starts running. Bachalo Bhagwan. But the danger was there before also. Na? Why are you running now? Because in the first phase, you realized it. There's a two different things. One thing is that something exists and you know it, but you don't realize. Knowing and realizing, there's a big difference. So in the first phase,
true,
you not only know, when first phase starts, you just know it. Uske pehle toh you don't know also. But by the first phase ends, you realize it. So in the first phase, the ending of the first phase is like this, that you lose some area of your life very badly. It's not necessarily finances or relationships or anything external, but internally you feel that unless I make this change, it's not going to happen. So then when second phase starts, you come to the battlefield. That is why they say it is the peak phase. Now you have gone to the doctor and the doctor has said, my dear sir, one glass of wine more and you're dead. One thing you do, you will be ripped apart in Sade Sati second phase. Because in the second phase, you are expected, not that you will, you are expected to become mature. Because you have got sufficient beatings.
Sure.
You still don't get punishments in the first phase. You just get beatings. There's a difference between beating and punishment. But in the second phase, if you behave like an ostrich, you will be punished very badly. So during the second phase, you see people, suppose they have a bad habit of speaking lies. So 20 years they have lied to everybody. Now first phase was over, so they realized that if I speak lies, maybe I will be caught and I will face humiliation. But again, as I said, you don't get punished in the first phase. Second phase comes, you speak a lie and it goes viral. So then you are forced to clear the mess. You must do it. Otherwise, you cannot move ahead in life. Your life will be halted. It will come to a complete standstill. First phase mein kya hoga? In Hindi they say na jugaad bazi, there's a word, you know.
Yeah.
Jugaad lagana. Trying to fix things, beating around the bush. All these things happen in the first phase. You are just, you know, crawling around. Maybe I can keep Saturn away from me.
Right.
But in second phase, no. You have addictions, you will be ripped apart. You will be fired if you are not working properly. But the question is, why are you not working properly? Because you don't like to work, right? You are doing a filthy, boring, disgusting job which you absolutely hate. In fact, there are people who mail to me during consultation that, can you tell me some mantra by which, you know, I can impress my boss? He's completely angry with me, he's pissed off with me, he's never satisfied. What can I do to please my boss? These are questions which people ask. So that's what happens in the second phase. You must take action. And that phase, it takes a toll. Why? Because you have to redo 1,000 actions which you were doing from last 10, 20 years. You have to rewire your consciousness. Now escaping doesn't work. And the first phase, the second phase will end like that. It goes, you are rewiring, And then by the end of the second phase, if you have done it properly, provide it. Because always remember, Sade Sati can come the second time also, right? It comes once in 30 years, so you may live till 60. So then you will get Sade Sati second version. So in the second phase, what happens is, by the end, there is sufficient ground for you to act. Where you realize that now is the time where I can take that next step. Next step means, let's take an example. Suppose somebody is in a job which that person doesn't like. Rather than saying not like, I would say absolutely hates. So in the first phase, they will start hating their job very badly. But still, they will still stay there. Then second phase, they will start doing something. Suppose they want to play the guitar. They are very good guitarists, for example. Then they will start making videos in YouTube, you know. Okay, then they will get some 10 views, 100 views, 1,000 views, 10,000 views. One video will go viral, 50,000 views. Then by the time the second phase ends, then people will come and tell him, hey, sir, why are you doing this job? You could be a guitarist full time, right? You don't need to do this job, you know. It's not required. So then when the third phase comes, you see how you can integrate that with your overall consciousness. That's very important, because just forming the ground is not enough. Because see, ultimately you are an individual. Whatever you do in life, it is career, relationship, spirituality, astrology, sports, whatever it is, it has to be harmonious with your life. If that is not there, it will not happen. So whatever you have done in the last 20, 30 years, which you corrected during the second phase, hopefully expected to, now you try to incorporate it with the other aspects of your life. But always remember, you are still in Sade Sati. So people think that, oh, the third phase is like, no, chill, it's almost done, you know. No, it's not done. Third phase is also very difficult. Why? Because now you have to not only rewire that area, but all areas of your life around what you did in the last 2-3 years. So third phase is a challenge of integration. And you have to rewire everything that is around you, around that. And then maybe you are happy. So that's what is my understanding of these three phases. And I have seen this working like right and left, black and blue. So the red signal is if you get a feeling during first phase that I'm not in the right place, then that's a red signal that during the second phase, you will leave it. All right. So that's the answer to your three phases.
Yeah, so it was a quite unique perspective to look at Sade Sati. And now we will take a short break here and we will again meet in the part two.
Yeah.